I built this aquaponics garden in the spring of 2023. I've been experimenting with different systems for over a decade now and have learned a lot along the way. But every season up until now, I've shut down my garden due to the cold Idaho winters. So this year, I'm gonna move my aquaponics garden into my garage. But before I show the final garage setup, let's go over the materials I used and some of the pros and cons of aquaponic gardens. When building the garden bed shelving, in the past I've used 2x6s and 4x4s. But around 5 years ago, I discovered galvanized steel unistrut, and it's well worth the extra cost for me. It lasts longer, has superior strength, and can easily be taken down and put back up if you ever have to move. It's basically like an erector set for adults, and I love playing with it. For my garden beds, I prefer these 50-gallon Rubbermaid stock tanks. They're strong, durable, and weather-resistant, and they're 12 inches high, or 12 inches deep, which is perfect for aquaponics gardening. You don't want to go much shallower than that, because certain plants with more robust root systems won't do very well. And it also keeps your water temperatures more stable to have more volume. I've used 50-gallon drums cut in half in the past, as well as IBC totes. And these are both good options, but they're not quite as easy to handle and durable as these Rubbermaid stock tanks. Both options are quite flimsy and much harder to shovel out when you need to clean out your beds. But if you can get your hands on some for free, they work well enough. Just make sure they weren't used to store any harmful chemicals. When it comes to plumbing an aquaponic garden, I find 3/4 inch to be the ideal size, which is what I'm using on this project with my PVC and bulkhead fittings. And as a side note, the plumbing of your system usually is the weak point, so make sure you cement all your PVC joints really well to prevent any floods or accidents in the future. My intentions for this video is more to give some guiding principles for those who are considering aquaponics gardening, but I do plan to make some more detailed videos on aquaponics gardening in the future. So if you'd like me to prioritize any subjects around this, please let me know in the comments and subscribe if you don't want to miss anything. Once the plumbing is measured, cut, and installed on the media beds, it's all downhill from there. The only thing left to do is install the bell siphons on top, which I'll explain later, fill the beds with media and water, and hook up our pump. So let's head into the garage to see the full setup. Here's the garden up and running. I haven't fully planted everything yet, but I did plant this first bed here with some chives, strawberries, and mint. They haven't really taken off yet, but we'll see how they do. There's only one mechanical component to this entire system, and that is the water pump that we have down here. And I'll list out all the components in the video description for those of you who want them. But basically how it works is the pump runs 24/7. It comes through the PVC pipe, up through these standpipes, and it slowly fills the media beds. Once it gets to the top though, this bell siphon is gonna be triggered, and then it's gonna create a siphon and quickly drain the water out. So the reason why this is important is it's constantly oxygenating the root zones of our plants several times every hour so that we don't get root rot with any of our plants. So that's the basics of how the system works, but I do want to talk a little bit more about bell siphons and the specifics of those, and then we'll go into the science of how aquaponics systems work. Let's go over how I built the bell siphon system on this grow bed. On the outside, I have a 4-inch piece of PVC pipe with holes drilled in it to let the water through but still hold the rocks back. In the middle, there's a 3/4-inch drain pipe cut to 9 inches, the height where I want my water level to stop. If we left it this way, we'd always have 9 inches of water in our grow bed at all times. So to solve this problem, we're going to put a bell siphon over the top of it. This way, our bed will constantly be draining and flooding, pulling in fresh oxygen to the root zones of our plants. To make the bell siphon, I used 2-inch PVC pipe cut at 12-inch lengths with a cap glued on top. On the other end, I cut 1-inch slots up from the bottom, still leaving 4 legs for the bell siphon to stand on. Here you can see the water flowing through the drain pipe at a constant rate. But when the bell siphon is applied, a siphon is created and the bed quickly drains. Since the flow rate of the water filling the bed is much slower than the rate of the water being siphoned out, the water level will eventually make it to the air holes in our bell siphon and the siphon will be broken. At this point, the grow bed will slowly fill again and the whole process will repeat itself, slowly filling and quickly draining several times per hour. Aquaponics is the combination of aquaculture, the raising of fish and other aquatic animals, with hydroponics, growing plants without soil. It's a closed-loop system where beneficial bacteria, fish, and plants all benefit each other. Here's the basics of how it works. After your system is set up for about a month or two, naturally occurring bacteria in the environment, called nitrifying bacteria, will form colonies on the media in your grow beds. When the fish wastewater is then pumped into the grow beds, these bacteria will break down the ammonia into nitrites and nitrates. These nitrates are a nutrient-rich food source for your plants and are readily taken up by them. Which is perfect, because all three of these compounds are poisonous to fish at high concentrations. So the fish waste provides food for the bacteria and plants in your grow bed. And in return, the bacteria and plants filter the water, returning clean water back to the fish. So as long as you create an acceptable environment for these three elements, you're going to have a fairly maintenance-free garden that produces fresh, organic vegetables. The preferred pH and temperature for the bacteria, plants, and fish in your system are all slightly different, but there's a healthy compromise at a pH of 7 and a temperature around 80 degrees Fahrenheit. If you want more specifics on this, please check the video description, but this is generally where an aquaponics system runs best. While these parameters are ideal, there is a fair amount of wiggle room you can work outside of. But below 50 degrees Fahrenheit, or above 95 degrees Fahrenheit, or below a pH of 6, or above a pH of 9, are danger zones. If you go outside these parameters for prolonged periods of time, your garden's going to be in trouble. If you want to learn more about aquaponics gardening, I plan to make a YouTube playlist and continually add content to it. I also plan to do a full course in the future, and I'll edit the video description notes with that information when it becomes available. But until then, let's quickly go over the 5 critical mistakes a beginner could unknowingly make when starting their aquaponics journey. Mistake number 1 is choosing the wrong media for your grow beds. Make sure the media you choose doesn't raise or lower the pH of your system. Otherwise, you'll be continually fighting to keep your parameters in check. The size of your media is also important. Shoot for around 3/4 inches in diameter. Smaller than this, and you run the risk of getting anaerobic, oxygen-poor zones in your bed. Larger than this, and you have less surface area for the beneficial bacteria in your garden. Mistake number 2 is poor garden design. Make sure that your garden's big enough so that you don't have large fluctuations in pH or temperature overnight. You should also have enough media filter beds to handle the fish waste that is produced. Mistake number 3 is choosing the wrong fish for your environment. Keep in mind the seasonal changes and the day and nighttime temperature fluctuations in your garden and plan accordingly. Mistake number 4 is overfeeding your fish. Excess food will spike the ammonia levels in your system. And the last mistake is adding too many fish before your garden has properly cycled. Remember, it typically takes 1 to 2 months for enough beneficial bacteria to build up to properly filter the fish waste. My aquaponics gardens don't always produce as well as my soil gardens, but they're fun, relatively weed-free, and self-watering.